gonna say the N-word.
That's racist! You can't say the N-word!
They see me rolling, they hating, patrolling and trying to catch me riding dirty, 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 trying to catch me riding dirty.
I have no idea how to breathe.
The branch snapped, and the bell... Hooray! Chuffed Duncan. As he was about to leave, the Fat Controller arrived.
Toby,
he said.
You're adopted!
Why is everyone so fucking stupid? Why aren't more people intelligent, like me?
Ah, fuck.
Can't wait to blow this motherfucker up with explosives.
But Thomas raced straight through the station. There was a rush of wind so big it blew the Fat Controller's hat right off his head.
How and why and how and why?
Hello, Freddy, whistled Sir Handel. I haven't seen you for years. Thomas didn't notice that the points had been changed. Thomas puffed into the sidings and biffed into the buffers. Sticky toffee splattered everywhere.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
Help! Cried Henry. Edward brought Rocky to lift Henry back onto the track.
Who the fuck are you?
Just then, Bertie arrived. What's happening? Asked Thomas. No one's getting out, Thomas, beeped Bertie, because no one is left on board.
Where the fuck is everyone?
Whoa, shooting star.
Boy, I am a comet, not a star.
Oh, sorry.
It's fine, it happens all the time.
Hello, viewers. You join us on a car ferry in the Baltic Sea, just off the coast of Poland. And the reason we're here is because we're about to embark on a road trip that no one's ever thought of doing.
Yeah, and the reason we're doing a road trip that no one's ever thought of doing before is, in these times, it's very difficult to do a road trip that someone has thought of doing before.
Yeah, if you think about all the places we've been to in recent years, places that were stable when we were there, that aren't anymore. Mozambique, Syria, Iraq, Burma, Ukraine, Russia. We couldn't go back to any of them. Or for different reasons, Argentina.
No, or Turkey.
Why can't we go to Turkey?
We're banned.
Yes, but it's not just the places where we've been before that there is a problem.
No, no, absolutely right. For this show, we thought, I know, we'll drive across the Sahara. Can't, too much terrorism. Then we said, let's follow in the footsteps of Lawrence of Arabia and go across the Sinai. Can't, too much terrorism. We wanted to go from Bangladesh to Mount Everest. Can't.
Why couldn't we do that?
You'd have to go through India.
Is that a problem?
Yeah, I'm banned from India.
Yeah. He is. Oh, yeah. He is. And anyway, it's because of all of that that we find ourselves here on a ferry in the Baltic Sea.
Yes, because we are about to undertake a 1,400-mile drive from, we've got the map here, actually, I'll fish this one out, from Gdansk, which is right up here on the Baltic, there, and then we go all the way down here to Bled in Slovenia. Mm. Nobody's done that ever. Gdansk to Bled.
And having decided to do a road trip that nobody's ever done before, Mr. Willman chimed in and said, OK, but you've got to do it in cars that nobody's ever used to do a road trip before.
And on that front, I'm the winner.
You're so not.
He was going fast. Then there was trouble.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Thomas!
Why do you have a giant balloon tied to your buffers?
But Thomas didn't hear him.
Alright, I get it!
Maybe I am a scurdy little engine, cried Scarloey.
But Diesel was in the yard too.
Now I'll show Thomas who's best, Diesel whispered. And he gave the trucks an extra hard shunt. Paint pots flew into the air and splattered down all over Thomas.
Where's my bloody car? Can anyone see an Aston Martin anywhere? Hello?
One day, Thomas was on his way to High Farm when Rosie stopped beside him. Rosie was a cheerful, chirpy little tank engine.
Fuck that, said Thomas. What a noise!
Will the owner of the lime green Honda please come to the front desk?
Are my lights on? No, I just wanted to see what you looked like, dude. Your car's fucking ugly.
Your heart, fiddle dee dee. Being a pirate is a wretched thing. Do what you want, cause a pirate is free. You are a pirate.
Well, when life gives you lemons.
James puffed back onto Edward's line.
It worked,
laughed James.
I'm first.
Suddenly the signal turned red and he applied his brakes as hard as he could. Edward tried to brake as well, but it was too late.
Fuck!
That's my boy. No, my boy!
Father, help!